The Delhi police has arrested the building owner, Mohammed Rehan, and his manager, Furkan, in connection with a factory fire incident in North Delhi, which claimed 43 lives. The case has been registered under sections like culpable homicide not amounting to murder, also negligence and conduct with respect to fire and combustible matter. Other people related to the owner have also been questioned. The incident, which took place early hours on Sunday, is said to be the second biggest fire incident in Delhi since the Upahar cinema tragedy back in 97, which had claimed 59 lives. Now, the Delhi Fire Service has declared that the building did not have fire clearance and no fire safety equipment were found in the premises. While the preliminary cause is said to be short circuit, further probe in the matter is being conducted by the Delhi Police's crime branch to see what exactly went wrong. But the concern at this point is not just about what happened in that building and not just about those who are struggling for their lives, even in the hospital as we speak, but about the other buildings that surround the area, which also have similar illegal factories running. So what's going to happen to that? Sukirti Dwivedi actually joins us from top of that one of those buildings. Sukirti, tell us, today morning, as shops open, as work resumes over there, what exactly are you seeing?
Well, Sonal, to give our viewers a vantage point, I'm standing on the top of the terrace of a building that is right next to the one where the fire incident took place. And if my camera person could show you what this entire area looks like, this is how the houses here are constructed right next to each other. These buildings that you see, if my camera person can lower down the camera a bit and show you, these particular three buildings are the one that caught the fire. This cream one that you see on the left, and then that white one, and that the cream one on the other side that's on the right. So these three buildings are all attached to each other. The fire started on the second floor and then spread to the other floors. These are the blackened windows and all these materials that used to be, that were used in the workshop. Those are the ones that you can see. And the only exit that could have been possible for those people was the one that would have led into the narrow lane that you see here, right next to this entire building. So this is where the exits open up. The other option that those people would have had was to run up to this terrace that you see that these buildings have. But whether the entrance to the terrace was also open at that point of time is not clear, or whether that entrance to the terrace was also locked, because sometimes in these fire situations people rush up to the terrace because that seems to be the only escape. But apart from that, they had no other way to escape or get an exit from anywhere else, because as you can see, all of these houses are right next to each other. These boundaries are attached, and within these residential locations itself, workshops are run on every other floor. There are portions that are divided, and that is where all of these labourers who come from UP and Bihar and all of these places, they tend to work. But there are no fire norms in place, no procedures. As you can see, there's barely any possibility of proper fire exits here. Neither can I see any kind of fire extinguishers being installed at any of these locations. So it would have been extremely dangerous in these narrow cramped lanes for such an emergency to have taken place. Sonal.